Hey guys, got another CD player for restoration. Decided to go with an older model. This one came out in 1991 and was manufactured in Japan. This one actually has a certification, as you can see there. October of 1991. And it looks like it's been used pretty good. I'm hoping most of the scratches on the lid will come off. Should. A little bit of spray nylon will take care of that. There's no major scratches on the front, on the face. It just really needs to be cleaned up. Built-in headphone amp. This one is the Sony cdp-491. So you can look it up. Some of the feet are loose on it. This little trap door to get underneath the laser. So what we're going to do is we're going to open it up. Or actually, let's fire it up first just to see if it even works. I took all the screws out to save time, but I haven't had a chance to try it. And it powers up. The door opens. Try CD. The door closes. It worked. Okay, so the issue was having is the door would open, but it wouldn't close by here. So what I did is, it's basically forcing it open and close and zooming in like that. It started working. Obviously, it's a belt issue, which I will show you what it was. Yeah, we'll have to take it apart, but the issue with it is it'll open the door, but it won't extend all the way out, and it doesn't hit a little toggle switch saying the door has been fully extended, and so it just basically will open the door and that's it. The issue with the belt is it'll open and close the door, but it won't wrap the gear around the, as you can see, that gear that wraps around like that. And what it does is it locks the door, and then it can move the laser up and down. But if the belt's dirty or weak, it'll open the door and close it, but it won't wrap it around that. So what we got to do is we got to take the door off and gain access to the belt and clean it up. And hopefully you can see that. Get some screwdrivers here. Never opened this one up, so I'm not too sure that it was a screw. It's not. It's just tabs. A little bit dirty, like, considering its age, it's pressing some worse. Could use a little grease in there. The belt is not loose or rotted, it's probably just dirty. Let's take some alcohol to it and see if that helps. First, yeah, I can see how it flips around like that. So if that belt is weak, it won't do that. Let's take it right out and clean it by hand. Oh yeah, there's some goop on there. Look at that. A little bit of wear, but still got elasticity. Clean up around the gears. These gears are dry, so I'm not going to bother oiling them because they're probably designed to be dry, and basically the oil is just going to run and make a hell of a mess, make everything slip. It's made it this far without grease, and it should be fine. Which way does this go? I think this goes up. Yep. And it goes like that. Or does it go like that? Nope, it goes up like that. Cool. Feels like it's really pulling now. Well, that's pretty dry. We'll see if we can put a little bit of oil on that track there. Let's get some oil. Gear. A little bit of oil over here on the track. Okay, let's plug this back in and see if it's even functioning. Just trying to close the door, so I'll show you. Yeah, there's still some life left in that belt. Slab a little grease in the track here. It's going to work like new. Hopefully. Go. Let's slip this in. Just want to make sure it reads before I go further and clean the faceplate and everything else. Come on. All right, let me figure out what I'm doing. It's just a timing issue. All right, and which way did this go? Well, I'm guessing it would go this way. Okay. Power it up, opens, closes. Oh, super smooth. Drop a CD in. Yep, read it, play. Plays like instantly, which is a surprise considering its age. Wow. Well, I also wanted to give you a close-up of the laser. Well, here's the... I wanted to show you guys the laser assembly. You can see the huge pots on the back. They don't do that anymore. Usually it's a single, or they don't do it at all. Back in the day, they always had those three huge pots. And actually, before they even had that, half the older ones in the 80s, half the unit was just one solid aluminum laser assembly. They were huge. But anyway, what I wanted to show you also was it's doing it again. So there's definitely an issue with the belt. It'll open, but it won't close. So I'm going to take it out and see what's going on. It might be a bad switch or something. Doesn't seem to really bounce back. It's sort of stretched out like oval. So I'm going to dig through my stuff and see if I have another one the same size. So it was still doing the intermittent. It would play and work for like a good hour. And then when you hit stop, it would stop, but it wouldn't start again. And the door would open, but it wouldn't close. So when I jiggled this, it closed and it started playing again. So my guess is these pins are just dirty. So I'm going to try cleaning them off. Hopefully it's not the cable itself. Alright, we'll try that. Seat it all the way in there. Alright, let's see what happens. Nope, still doing it. But when you see what I mean? Could be the cable's just, it is kinked pretty bad here. Or it could be a solder joint on the actual board itself. Plays. And I don't think I have another one of those ribbon cables, unfortunately. I've got other parts though. I got another transport, exactly the same as the one that's in there. This one actually is pretty cool. I saved this one from a really, really old unit. What I like about it is the spindle is brushless. You don't see very often. Usually it's brushed. It's a brushed motor. Cheaply made. That one's pretty cool. It's for parts though. Yeah, see, it's still doing it. Seems to be on that side. Oh well, we're going to have to take it apart and go over all the solder joints and everything else. Well, I ruled it out being the belt. And I ruled it out being the ribbon cable for sure. These switches here, one's to open the door, one's to close the door. I have a feeling one of them is working intermittent. It's probably got some dirt in it or whatever. We're going to take the motor apart and take the board off here and take a look at those and see what they're, if they're serviceable. Should be able to just lift this right out. So it's gonna take to get that apart. Well, the contacts had a lot of goop in them, so I'm hoping that's all it was. I cut that part out of the video because it took a while with the loop to get in there and figure out how to take it apart. Oops. Oh yeah, that's great. I don't know how that went in there. Well, we'll have to figure it out. Oh, not much to figure out. Just figured it out. There we go. Now we'll see if this makes a difference. I have a feeling it's just the switch wasn't working, so basically it was just, you know, saying there's an issue and it wouldn't go any further, which is totally normal. Okay. Sure it spins. Yep. I think that might have been what it was. Just dirty contacts. Basically cleaned them like I was working on an engine. You know, I put a little bit of sandpaper in there and probably used contact cleaner, but or alcohol. Could use that. But they were black. The ends were black on them when you looked at them through the loop. So I'm guessing that's what it was. CD. Reads, plays. Problem there. That's it. That's what it was. Basically, I wasn't making contact on one of the switches, and basically it was basically erroring out. Basically, it didn't give you an error on the display. I mean, actually, it'd even say play when you hit play, but it wouldn't give you an error message. But that's all it was. It was a belt, one of the little reed switches thingies, and that's it. Plays great. Let's get a little bit of spraying on and see if we can clean it up. Wish I could really play it, but I can't. And I don't care what people say. I find the older CD players actually sound better than the newer ones. If it's just me. I don't think it's me. Since I think half the problem is over time, like to sell a CD player, over like the Admash and double whatever. You know what I mean? Anything to sell it. The older ones were just basically just a CD player and a DAC. Hey, this one has a nice sound with the headphones on through the headphone amplifier, which I noticed right away when it was playing. So try it again. No problems. Oh, I guess I shouldn't put that on yet. I gotta take the face off and clean the LCD. The CD player has seen a lot of owners. Look at the fingerprints on it. It's brutal. It's just been around. Just want to grab some spray nine, see if I can get those fingerprints off really tomorrow. Use a little bit of concentrated, see if that'll work. Not much. See, that's it's not just fingerprints, it's also rust. This stuff works really good on plastic though. Plastic coming out. Alright, yummy. Too bad. I think there were scratches on the front. There isn't. It's just there's just smudges. What's it gonna take to get the front off? A bit of trickery here. Not too sure why they got that there like that. There we go. Guess that's some kind of grounding strap. Yummy. That's for the headphones. How they used to anchor stuff back in the day. There we go. We'll get this out of the way. That'll have to be cleaned as well. I like to clean the lens on the inside, especially if it was smoker owned. I'll get the name of the IC that's for the headphone amplifier, in case anybody's wondering what it is. Does sound pretty good. Nice and bright and very loud. Like it needs much cleaning, but we'll do it anyway. There's a little bit of haze in there. Man. Let's quickly get the model number of that amp. Cool. I do like the way it's built. Okay, the IC is RC4556S. And underneath it says Ray L106 JA. And on the board, it doesn't say much on the board, it just says Sony IC501. It's got two. Not so well soldered in their capacitors. I'm not gonna use Indust on that plastic. I'm gonna go get some glass cleaner. So better yet than I've gone this far, I'm gonna take this out. Power button, and we're just going to basically just stick this in the sink and wash it with soap and water. That's got a lot of crud in there that I got to get rid of. And one thing that really makes me cringe is when I watch one of these restoration videos on audio and Buddy uses spray paint. It blows me away. If it's worth salvaging, it should turn out like that. You know what I mean? That's pretty good. Pretty clean considering what it was. Inside note, I'm gonna have to let it sit and dry out a bit, but it's not bad. Be good. Cleaned up pretty good considering its age. And like you saw before and after, so that's just the faceplate. It's pretty good. So I'm just going to quickly wipe down the dust out of this thing, and then we'll slap it back together and see if we can bring back the case. Like I said, I'm not going to paint it. I've seen videos on that. Buddy will like literally restore something that looks like it's been sitting in a junkyard covered in dirt or something. Like, I don't see the point of it. It's not going to work the same. We're not going to smell the same. There. This wasn't smoke around, so that's a plus right there. Looks like it's got a little bit of juice or something there. Don't care. Just slowly get this baby back together. Give it a quick test. I wouldn't say it's brighter, but it's cleaner. Let's get the lid on it. Now this is where it's going to take some effort. Spray 9, this stuff concentrated is pretty strong. It should get most of the buffs out. Scratches, it's not going to get out. could be worse considering its age. Ugh, nasty. It's coming up pretty good actually. It's getting a lot of the buffing out, of the scratches. Good layer of dirt, and it's a little bent over here. I'm going to have to straighten that out. Get some more paper towel. Alright, let's see how that turned out. Yeah, she scratched up pretty good. Nothing to do about that. Just make sure you put all your components on top of it, you won't see it. But it's actually pretty good, actually. It's turned out pretty good. It's drying here. It's just some deep scratches in the back. The front's pretty good. Buff it a little bit. Let's see if we can straighten the lid up before we put it back on. A little bit mashed right there. That didn't take much. I said that piece of plastic was floating around inside. That is it. I think it turned out pretty good, considering its age and what shape it was in when it first came in. A couple more wipes, cuts through some more of the grime. It's respectable. Geez, even the lid is dirty. And I didn't even notice I had their mic off. Anyway, it's done. Let's get a good quick test and call it a day. And that's how you restore a very old CD player. Well, I wouldn't say it's old, but I'm going to try and get old stuff like this to restore, get more enjoyment out of it. Not bad. And the beauty part is, I still have extra parts down the road if I need it. Later, guys.